If this is your first time to the channel, consider subscribing, press the bell icon, and never miss an update. Hey guys, so this is our Suzuki Shogun, which has come for a full ground up restoration. So, some of you guys might be really upset with me because I didn't finish one project and I'm moving on to other. See, one thing which is very critical about this project is this has to go for plating and zinc dipping tomorrow itself. So I'll have to dismantle this bike and give it to the plating guy, which will be done shortly. I'll be dismantling this, but before that I want to give you a general situation of what is what. As you can see, this side cover is okay, but it is held with some steel wire. That is because it was not locking in place, because the small rubber thing where this locks is kind of missing. So some parts have to be taken care of. And secondly, if you look, overall the condition is not horrible, but it is still workable. Like these levers, both side, we will reuse. These yokes, we'll buy new because they are not very expensive. These switches we will reuse. The meter we will reuse, but we will change the these two cases. The dome is perfect, so we are going to reuse the dome. We have the visor, which is not with me at the moment, but I will get it. Indicators, the front indicators are good. The back indicator is okay, but one side is slightly broken, so we will change that. We will change the seat cover. Then we will give all the nuts, bolts, bits and bobs for zinc dipping. So that is where we will change these footrest. The chain sprocket needs changing. We won't change the stands because these stands are in good condition. So we will just clean them thoroughly and paint them. This gear lever would be painted, that rubber would change. Plus these kind of things, I will re-insulate them properly so that they start looking little presentable. Then the front mudguard of this bike is not from Shogun, it is actually from a RX. So this is a Shogun mudguard that I have from one of my previous builds. I'm going to use this, but if you notice, there is a small piece that comes here which is cut off. I have that piece, so I will get this fixed. Plus we have to get rid of a couple of these holes which are there. We'll shut them up. So that is the action plan. Other than that, we'll change all the cables. And the best part is I have actually set myself a challenge in this. The challenge is I will try to restore this whole bike under 10,000 rupees. Yes, I'm not kidding. That is what is going to happen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to reuse maximum number of stuff and see how we can save money. So things like the kicker or the gear lever are better to buy new because getting them plated is expensive. So only things that would be plated in this bike is, this is not going for plating, this is actually good, I'll get it polished. These four nuts plus this nut, five, and then these nuts also I'll get plated. Then four nuts of the shock, rest everything I'll get them painted. The shocks are in pretty nice condition. Footrest, we will get rear footrest new. And then this piece I have already procured, so that is part of this 10k budget. This thing we will paint. We'll paint all the chassis bits most likely on Sunday. And I'll use a flap disc to make this little presentable. We'll see what we can do here, because that kind of looks ugly. The engine will be completely rebuilt, which is within the budget. And I will have these hubs painted nicely. Everything else will go for zinc dipping so that we can reuse maximum number of components that we are taking out of this bike. So it is going to be a very good budget build, and it would actually give you guys a lot of pointers on how you can actually build a bike in budget if you know you do the right set of things. So that is the plan on this bike. Mostly everything is there with me. Some of the cables are new, like you know the accelerator cable was something that I installed in it about 3-4 months ago, but anyways we'll change it. We'll keep the old accelerator cable as a backup for you know when we need it in future. The front and rear tires are almost brand new. You can see the condition of the front tire, you can see the condition of the rear tire. These are almost brand new. All these plastics can be reused, so which I'm going to do. The air filter box is of decent condition. So other than that, if you look at the side covers, this one is repaired even before I got it, so I just kept it like this. This one was also repaired, but what happened is over a period of time this kind of started falling apart. So I will get this fixed if I don't have a replacement cover. I'm not going to buy those new covers available because the quality is pathetic. As soon as you start fixing things after paint, they will start, you know, falling apart. So what we are going to do is we are going to repair this, or I am going to use one of those covers which I have in my stock. I'm going to get the seat cover redone, so that is not going to cost much. I'll give you guys a very detailed breakup of what costs how much. So tomorrow the plan is to go ahead and paint everything. Not tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm going to give everything for you know, plating, zinc dipping, etc., so that we can get it next week or the week after that. At that time we will get the wheels trued. Next Saturday I'll give it for truing, or maybe if I get it before that I'll give it for truing. And then you know, once it is back from there, then we'll start the rebuild process. So everything is in pretty decent condition cosmetically. Like what you see is surface rust. So this can be brought back to a very good condition. So that is what we are going to do about this bike. So we are going to get everything fixed as it is supposed to be, and then keep it well under the 10,000 rupees budget. So that is the thing about this bike. Now let me put you guys on a tripod and start taking it apart. So like you guys saw, we dismantled the Shogun completely. I want to get the oil seals and the bearings, then I will take apart the engine, because after that we'll just fix everything back and do with the build, because I seriously don't want to take everything apart and keep it, because there is nothing to be zinc dipped in the engine, to be honest. The crank I checked, right now there is no play, so most likely we don't have to rebuild the crank also. Once we take it out, we'll check again if there is any play. So the noise most likely was coming from the top end bearing, which is dropping a couple of needles, so that is in pretty nasty condition. Anyways, so now what we are going to do is we are going to buy these spares. So I'll make the list of those spares, and that would be in another video. So I didn't want to make this video extremely long. So right now what we have done is we have actually classified everything separately. Things which are to be painted are here, except for the seat of course, but there are some brackets which we can use for painting. Then things which are to be plated, electricals and plastic parts are here. next things, these are things which are to be zinc dipped, so I have to add a couple of more stuff, like, you know, these axles, etc., plus those brake cams and those brake rods. So I'll get all those zinc dipped. Most likely we will try to see if we can give it tomorrow. Then most of these things, like, you know, the brake pedal, the clutch lever, I mean the levers and all those things would be bought new, because those are not very expensive, and you know, basically refinishing that will be a headache in itself. So this chassis, as you can see, is pretty nasty here, and it is kind of little corroded here as well, so we'll have to box this section. It's only bad on this side, this side is kind of fine. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this piece off and see if we can weld a nut on the other side, so that, you know, we can put the seat bolts in. So we'll do that on both the sides. Plus we have to box that section. We'll have to get a new mudguard. So we'll make a list of things which we need to buy. Other than that, you know, the dismantling is almost complete. Most likely I won't cut the wheel completely. Let me see if I can paint it with the spokes masked. So that is my plan as of now. So if that can be done, I think that would be the route I would choose. So yeah, that is something that we will plan on Sunday. So tomorrow we will just give all these parts for basically zinc dipping, and let's hope that all of this is back by next week. So yeah, that's about today's video. See you guys in the next one. Bye bye.